Hello guys, in this video I'm going to tear down and attempt to repair this Microsoft Wireless Mouse 1000. I have this for almost 2 years now, together with a wireless keyboard from the same set, and it worked perfectly. The battery lasts a lot of time, but now it's starting to develop a problem. You cannot really use the scroll anymore. You can see it turning here, but it is turning without the normal jumps that you have on a scroll button. And it does not register. Only if you force it a little bit, then it starts to jump and register. But yeah, you cannot really do that because you move it 10 times and only one it registers. So I think something is sleeping inside. It has a little bit of play around there. So yeah, let's take this apart. Probably it has some screws under these pads here, maybe one in the back, I don't know. But yeah, I will give it a try. It's turned off. I will remove the accumulator. This is an annoying problem with this mouse. The echoes seem to get really stuck in here, so they are pretty hard to take out. I have no clue why this is happening, but it has happened from the start. Okay, one screw there. Maybe you can see it. Okay, my screwdriver is ready, and yeah, I'm going to take this off. Maybe it doesn't even have screws here, I don't really know, but most of them have, so I'm betting on that. Nope, it doesn't, so I can put it back. Let's undo this one and see what we get. It might just have a ton of clips. Let me turn on my light here. Yeah, way better. I thought the light from the outside is enough, but not today. I actually didn't take this thing apart until now, so yeah, I might stop the video for a moment to try and understand how it gets taken apart. Okay, made some progress. I started to take this off, but then I realized something. This pad, actually, it's in two pieces. So first I only removed the first one, and then I realized there is another one underneath, and the screws are there. So I'm going to completely take this off, put it aside, and we have two screws here. And now I realize that maybe I did the same thing here and I only took the first layer. So there might be screws under the second layer. But I will undo this and see if it starts coming apart, because I can understand if it still has some screws in the front or there are only these three in the back, two here and one there. In the middle. Hopefully it doesn't have any more screws, but we will probably see. Okay, it doesn't, so the front is screwless. Okay, one screw here for the light pipe. And yeah, let me try and figure out what is happening. It's a little bit dirty inside. I will give it a quick clean. Hopefully you can see what's happening here. Okay, so I don't know how obvious this is on the camera, but the outside of the wheel spins and the inside remains in position. So I must take this off. but the question is how. Usually you just pull on the free end and then pull everything out, but this one seems to be a little bit tighter, so I have to investigate a little bit more. Okay, I'm going to... I don't really know if you can see anything. Weirdly, the light is very, very bad today, but I didn't do anything different from other videos, so I don't really know what's happening. Okay, I will take out this connector. And it seems that this comes out. And as you can see, this probably in some models was made to take two batteries, but in this one only one battery. So now we have some more screws here. The good part is all the screws are identical, same size and shape, so no problem with that. Okay, this is out and the wheel is out. I must say this feels really good in the hand, so it's really well built, pretty thick PCB. I really like it. Of course, now I have a very good chance of cleaning everything around here. The button is still in place. Make sure you when you put it back together, it slides where it should be. Okay, and now this thing, and it just comes apart like this. Now let me try and understand what happened here. It doesn't seem to be really, really... Oh yeah, on the plastic there is lots of oil. It was greased here from the factory, and maybe that slowly found its way between the plastic and the rubber, or oils from the fingers, although this wasn't particularly dirty. I was expecting it to be way dirtier, but yeah, I will give it a really good clean, and after it's completely clean and I put it back together, I will put some one or two drops of super glue, so that will absolutely never ever move, no matter what gets in there. So yeah, let's clean this. Everything is clean. Let me put it together and see what it does. Okay, as you can see, although it is completely clean, it is still slipping. So maybe this rubber in time gets a little bit bigger. Not from wear, just from how the rubber behaves when getting older. So yeah, not really funny, but nothing I can do. Try and put some glue on this. Hopefully I still have glue in here. Yes, I do. My hand seems to be shaking today quite a lot, so I'm sorry about that. Okay, I got a little bit of glue here. Man, my hands are shaky today. Especially when I squeeze on this this tube, I don't really know why. Okay, let me see how I can get this in place. Didn't really think about this from the get-go. I could get lots of super glue on my hands, but it's a little bit too late now. Okay, decent enough. And the excess super glue, maybe you can see it here, I'm going to try and move it towards the plastic. This got messier than I would have liked. On this side at least, this one is really good. So yeah, doesn't really matter because all you see from the wheel is this. If my camera would actually focus. Was this thing always focused on the desk? I hate it, I really do hate it. You can see some super glue here. Not on this side, but doesn't really matter. Let me see if this thing, yeah, it's already glued. So at this point I'm gonna let it dry for a few minutes and then start putting everything back together. Okay, the super glue is dry. As you can see, I've put super glue all around it on both sides, and then I put some grease that does not corrode or eat plastic. Also, it's good for rubber because, as you know, super glue leaves those white marks when it dries up, and grease makes sure they don't show up anymore. And this also has to be greased in this plastic cuts where it stays. So at this point I'm going to start putting it back together, and this for sure will never slip again. I must say, this is way, way, way better than what it was. And I just realized that this thing probably started to slip a little bit half a year back, and it progressively got worse. And I just noticed it when it was really, really bad. So it should be working way better now. So let's put the rest of it together. And it's 100% finished. It makes a little bit of weird noise, but I think super glue vapors got into the areas where plastic on plastic friction is happening, but that should disappear rather quickly, so no problems there. And yeah, it is 100% working. So what can I say, pretty simple fix, and you have no clue that it was fixed is exactly like it was before. So yeah, thanks for watching, like, dislike, subscribe, and see you in the next video. Bye.